define function values. Our goal is to evaluate a given function given different inputs. I'd like to relate this to something that we've already done this semester. Many times functions are written as equations like y equals 5x minus 2 or y equals x squared plus 4. Before, when we were finding points on the graphs of these equations, we picked various x values and found corresponding y values. Here's a simple example. Evaluate y equals 5x minus 2 when x equals 4. We know the process is essentially to substitute 4 in 4x and evaluate. So we have y is equal to 18. There are several ways to express this relationship. One way would be to write it as an ordered pair. When x is 4, y is 18. With the new language of inputs and outputs that come with functions, we could say that when the input is equal to 4, the output is equal to 18. We substituted 4 in for x. X is our input, and y was equal to 18. Y was our output. Let's combine this thought with functions. Let's say that we're given f of x is equal to x squared plus 1, and we are asked to evaluate f of negative 4. Negative 4 is our input. Take a look at this notation, though. Notice how this x has been replaced with negative 4, and that is essentially how you evaluate f of negative 4. You replace or substitute x with negative 4. Negative 4 squared plus 1 gives us 16 plus 1, or 17. So f of negative 4 is equal to 17. Again, negative 4 would be considered our input. 17 would be considered our output. I'd also like to make the connection that this represents one point on the graph when x is negative 4, y is equal to 17. Most often, x is regarded as the input, y is the output. Okay, let's go on with another example. F of 7, so this becomes 7 squared plus 1. 49 plus 1 is 50. So just to clean it up, f of 7 is equal to 50. One more example, f of k. Now this may look a little confusing, but essentially we're going to be doing the same thing. Now we're going to replace x with k. Same function, so f of k is equal to, instead of x squared, we have k squared plus 1. Now we can't do anything else because these are not like terms, nothing simplifies. So that would be our final form. F of k is equal to k squared plus 1. Let's take a look at a couple more involved examples of evaluating functions. A function subtracts the input from the square of the input. A description of f is given by f of x is equal to x squared minus x. Our goal is to find f of x plus h. Or in other words, our input is x plus h. The question is, what would the output be? Well, let's replace x with x plus h. So we're going to square it, and then we're going to subtract it. Okay, remember, there's no shortcuts to squaring x plus h. We have to write this out twice and FOIL it. That would give us x squared plus 2hx plus h squared. You can check me on that if you'd like by writing it out and multiplying it. Next, we want to eliminate the parentheses here. We're going to subtract this quantity. Some of you may have been taught to put a 1 there and distribute a negative 1. Whichever method you're used to doing, go ahead and make sure that you get minus x minus h. And in fact, there are no like terms here. So we are done. F of x plus h is equal to the sum and difference of all these terms. The last example I would like to take a look at, we want to find f of x plus h minus f of x all over h, or divided by h. Okay, let's take this one step at a time. Now, this previous problem does give us f of x plus h. It gives us this piece of this fraction. So let's rewrite that. We have x squared plus 2hx plus h squared minus x minus h. Minus f of x, we have to subtract the quantity x squared minus x. So if we subtract both of those terms, you would get a minus x squared. And then if we subtract a minus x, of course that would be plus x. All of this would be over h. Notice we're not substituting h in because they didn't give us f of h, they just gave us the variable h. Let's see if we can simplify this. First off, let's look at the numerator, and we'll notice there are some terms that are opposites. So we have an x squared here, minus x squared there. We have minus x and plus x. Let's rewrite what we have so far. We have 2hx plus h squared minus h. Now, dividing all of that by h, notice they all have an h in common, so what I'm going to do is divide them all by h individually. Remember, you're allowed to do that as long as you're dividing by a monomial, one term. And the reason I did that, it's very easy to simplify these now. Notice how the common factor of h here and here, one common factor of h here, that would turn into h to the first power, and h over h would simplify as well. So what's left? We have 2x plus h, and then this is minus 1. So this entire fraction that involves the function notation is equal to 2x plus h minus 1. This is actually called the difference quotient that will show up later on in the semester. I hope that helps explain how to evaluate functions.